Number four, King of the Hippo Edition number two. We are now going into a low qualifier on Ghost Lake, and the players can choose between Goth and Persians. With me is the great, the one and only MBL.
Hello.
Oh, that was friendly. So, Goth or Persians on Ghost Lake, what do you think will be the choice? What would you go for with what strategy?
Goths, for sure.
Why?
Because of the endless help. I don't think it's really useful to go for Persia. Like, you can think, like, okay, late game, elephants. But then again, you have six players that might pick Goths, and everyone will have helps. So, maybe elephants, scorpions, but it won't be good enough for the Goths flood. And Goths can also do onagers to kill scorpions and bomber cannons, so I don't think Persia is a good choice.
Okay. Yeah. You did play a qualifier before, qualifier number two, with CM Hunger Games,
yes.
Chinese and Franks. Tell me something about your experience in this one.
I think the Franks was the worst choice, because you saw as soon as the Frank ran out of paladins, they had really nothing to have. I think the bomber tower approach was a bit better in the middle than going for Chukunus, so that's maybe where I did my mistake. Then again, players need to focus to the middle, or else it can turn out really bad. What's interesting here is that you can't make buildings around the wonder because of the ice.
Exactly that, and with that info, we are jumping into game number four. It is King of the Hippo qualifier number four, second edition. We are in low qualifier on Ghost Lake, and the players had the chance to choose between Persians or Goth. Let's take a look what players did pick, and it seems like five Persians and three Goths. So that should be interesting, MBL.
Yeah, that's very interesting, because that's gonna make it really difficult for the Goths, because you can see a lot more elephants, and that's gonna be an issue. So it gives the Persia more a bigger advantage, you know, if more pick Persia. That's what I think, at least.
Yeah, that might be very true. So let's introduce a player. We're starting in green, the wildest moose picking Persians. Then we go to the south, it's Dinomar with Persians as well. Then we have Foghorn, I think he's from the Netherlands. Then we have ZZ Odette with Gors. Another Persian's Arta. I think this is will work for Ice Cream or something, one of the most funniest guy in the Twitch chat, but not the funniest guy when it comes to working hours for female villagers on wood. Then we have Hurricane, so the only Goss actually facing or being close to each other, and Euler being Persians as well. Five Persians, three Goss. You think a Persian will win this one?
They definitely have the better chance, but I mean, everything can happen, and a really long distance to the middle, and I actually think the Goths will have the advantage when it's this distance and you can't have buildings around. The elephants will be pretty much unprotected from castle fire against the Halps, and only thing that can save the elephants are scorpions, but they won't last long either, I think.
Especially not against a lot of... Oops! Green losing a villager there after a lot of micro. Okay, let's take a look at the blue positioning. He can build pretty far close to the monument itself. Will that be a big advantage for him?
Well, if you look at gray, he also can go to that tip of the map. He's really close as well, and so is green. So it's not only blue that can go to there. I think there will be a little fight there. But it depends if they scout it or not. But I like how Odette and Orange are positioned, because they're pretty far from enemies and they have a big corner they can boom in and stuff. Instead of starting in the middle, like for example Teal. He doesn't have too much space. He can boom up to the right, but yeah, really close to the ice as well. Not really ideal.
Yeah, and it's
green,
super tough to walk.
Green has a terrible position, in my opinion. I'm not sure who has the worst. I mean, Odette and Arta are pretty close together, so there might be a fight between those two. Who do you think have the worst position?
I personally think that Teal is very exposed. He can't wall the front, and it's so easy for purple to attack him from behind. Green can kind of wall his back to be safe from purple, but that will be so much tougher for Teal.
It's really tricky to be in the middle, I think.
Okay, do you have any special strategies like when to pick the wander? For example, if you think, okay, I want to make it a fast game, that you send your scout earlier, then I want to make it a longer game and save my scout.
Well, I don't know. I just like to sit back in a bit, let other people fight, and then when it's getting close, I'll send cheap units into the wander and let my and just like make them lose control again and then retreat and just play it like back and forth like that until I can probably take control. But I don't know, unlucky things happen in my game at least that made me lose it that way, so I don't know, it's probably not the right way to go since it didn't work, but
Well, yeah, it's tough with only a sample size one to judge a strategy because obviously there are so many factors. I think in a like 8-player FFA, you basically have 12.5%, and if you have a good strategy, you can maybe go up to 15-20%. So it still fails nearly every time, even if you have a good strategy.
It's like I feel like the people that goes for the wonder first, they always seem to lose. That's my experience at least. But someone has to do it, you know. Someone has to be the one going for the wonder, trying to take it. But
Yeah, we had.
this seems so tricky with the ice. I'm not sure how this is gonna work.
How do you like the different civilizations and map choices in this King of the Hippo?
I like that. It's like it's more of a variety, you know. So it gives more opportunities for, but I think that in the Hunger Games it was pretty obvious that you should go for Chinese since it's like no TC start and they simply have better trash for a long game. But yeah, if you can do something with the Franks, it's also good. Yeah, like everything. I like it how it is, but I just don't seem. Have you had Ghost Lake before in this tournament?
Nope.
Okay, because I don't see how this game is gonna end.
Okay.
Like, because how are you gonna keep units for 100 years if you don't have buildings around to protect it?
I think people would kill each other quite a lot. So I think we will only see at the end like three or four people contesting the monument at like mid-Imperial Age.
Yeah, that could
Because
be.
for example, purple will not really contest for the monument, but can easily swipe out either teal or green. So then we're down to seven. If, for example, if blue now attacks into the middle, orange can easily attack him. Yellow and red have to fight first. So yeah, it's not like everyone can look into the monument like on Chaos Pit, for example.
Yeah, I guess what you mean. But then again, I feel felt like in my game at least, if I attacked my enemy while people were in the middle, that was a huge risk because then I felt like I didn't have control what was going on in the middle, and I felt like the game could be over anytime. So I think the players feel like they want to have the control of the middle as well, so that I'm not sure if they're gonna focus on each other too much. When the time is ticking down, yeah, they're gonna just start going for the middle, so we'll see.
Yeah,
But
it
go
is
ahead.
tough to control. I thought like Persian could go for like 150 army, which could basically defeat 3 to 4 normal armies. That's what I kind of anticipated in this game.
That can happen. Yeah, I think like in Ghost Lake, elephants actually can be good. You have a really, really good mass of them. And maybe monks as well to heal. Scorpions, but it's gonna take a long time for the Persian to be able to make it, and I don't think the other people should allow it.
Yeah,
We'll see.
that's true. And even if this game ends pretty quickly, we still have some Deathmatch show games coming up after
Oh.
this one, with Kellen, Jitbur, KD, and me playing some 2v2s.
Oh, nice.
Yeah,
Yeah.
so actually, those three players are hoping for a very short game here.
Are you on team with Kellen?
I think we will play random teams.
Oh, okay, cool.
And team random, yeah.
Yeah.
So you just have a small mixture.
Yes.
Let's see, Harry Kane, funny pun in his name. Trying to wall himself. Yellow and red are doing weird walls here. Odette actually going for stable.
Yeah.
Teal walling himself, but he's so exposed, I don't really see how that can be super effective. Like, weird Pelly's that would wall nowhere close to his gold.
Yeah, it's really weird walls I've been seeing right now, but you see, like, most of the Persians are going for the boom approach. You can see the two gods player, or two of the gods players are going for stables, while one the other gods going for market as well. So gonna be a lot of people booming here, I would think.
Yeah, that's what we were kind of expecting, honestly. But yeah, as I said, like, even you, it's impossible to be super safe. No one has very strong onagers, you don't have any good walls, no bomber towers. So, if the enemy wants to attack you, it's so super tough to, yeah,
Yeah,
defend.
there's a cool.
You have to invest a lot of pop into actual defending. So, explain the game before you played. You went for like 140 villages before actually clicking up to Imperial Age. What the reasoning behind that?
Yeah, I just. It's just for booming, saving up resources, because I know that I have a lot of time and I can just relax while the other people are fighting. Because I knew the game wouldn't end. People are like, I don't know. ACCM had an opportunity, but until that time, I knew I would have enough army, like at like 70 years. That's like when I aim to have a good massive army. Till
Okay.
then, I just relax, boom up, get my eco sorted out. So.
Okay, okay.
Also, I stayed on like 150, 160 villagers the whole game, just to have like 10,000 of each resource so I could go on in the long run. But then Purple miraculously took the Wonder with a, like, he had like 5 halbs and a ram left in the middle.
Nah.
So I think the two canoes from Robo probably didn't get in the middle fast enough.
Yeah, exactly. There were two onagers from Purple, and
Yeah.
Robo did retreat way too far back.
Yeah, he could have just took a stagger formation or split, and he probably could have tried to snipe them down because Chukanus are really strong against Onagers.
That's true.
But yeah, this is what makes it so fun. It's so unpredictable. You never know. Like the guy who won is like, he was like about 1500, and
Yeah.
like he managed to like take the game. So
Yeah, against like three top experts.
Yeah, it's like, that's what makes it fun, you know. Sucks to be out of it because I want to play more of it again. Again, I'm fucking annoyed. But it's fine. But yeah, I think it's a fun tournament, so I want to play more, you know. So it sucks to be out. But chances are small, so yeah.
Yeah, obviously it's always super tough, and
Yeah.
yeah, the qualifiers are pretty a bit more filled than last edition, where we had like one or two with six players. Now we
Nice.
mostly have eight. I think one time we had seven.
Yeah.
So, okay, if you are Goth, what would you go for as an army composition?
Right now I would go for a mix of halbs and champs. Also add scorpions, bomber cannons, and onagers. So, like, a mix of everything basically, but not Huskarl, because that's just a big waste of resource in my opinion.
Okay,
Like,
why is that?
Huskarl can't do anything. Not to Persia, or not to. And not to gods. And they're way too more expensive than champions.
I think champions cost 13 gold and Huskarl's 26 or something like this.
Yeah, champions are really cheap, so.
But Huskarl's maybe against Scorpions of Persians?
Well, that's why I want to have Bomberkens in the back
Okay.
and Onagers.
Okay, makes sense. And what's your ideal composition if you are Persians?
Hopefully, I would be able to mess a lot of elephants, scorpions, and monks. But it's really costly, so yeah, that's but it's the best unit composition in my opinion. What about you? What do you think?
I personally go for a one push attack there, like a super risky strategy. Not participate at all in the fights. Wait for 160 army, and pray for one big push. That's probably my strategy with Persians.
Yes.
But that's like, I kind of have to rely on people not losing the game in general, and I think that's like not a very teamy strategy, but that would have been my strategy on this map, yeah. Then, like, I think like 160 Persian army is just like, even if you have three Gauss players, you can't outspam this.
Yeah, more or less. I think you're right. It's
But
gonna be tricky.
yeah, I've kind of feared that too many. Oh, safe was 8 HP there. I thought like too many top players would go for a very campy strategy on this one. That's why I made it a low, because I think like those players are like taking more the fun into it and
Yeah,
producing
hopefully.
and not taking every strategical decision to a maximum there.
Yes. Yeah, I predict this to be a long game, but it also can be a short game. It can be like it can go both ways.
Well, depends on how the meta game will go concerning killing your neighbors.
Yes, I agree. But right now, I think Gray is looking very good with his boom, compared to the others. But then again, it doesn't really matter this
Yeah,
early
I think so.
because. But then again, if he's planning on doing what you're thinking about, then I think he has a good advantage. Like if he goes for the early push with the 160 army.
Yeah, I think I wouldn't go for the early push. I would like wait till one or two pushes failed and
Oh,
then go.
yeah.
By the way, we said like, yeah, let's see how the players will eliminate each other. I don't ever see Red not attacking Yellow here. He's so far in his face, so many resources, so much wood, gold spots they can fight for. And now Yellow goes for three stables here.
Oh. He's thinking about killing someone. Maybe he wants to attack Red. Not sure.
Now building a castle and already having queued up a lot of farms. Guys, so that's something you don't really want to do. Queue up farms
Oh.
before like reaching late Imperial Age.
Yeah. But he has like 1000 wood, so he
Yeah.
probably has. You don't really see it very often, but I guess in his case it doesn't really matter. Look at Teal's walls. He's trying to secure a whole big area, trying to
Yeah.
take the corner in the right.
And there are two extra gold spots, so makes kind
I
of
think
sense.
Red, no, that should have probably taken the spot, first in a corner and not walled herself like that, but then again, she might recover the corner later.
Gold. Red is missing two of his gold spots. He has a third, like, or fourth neutral gold
Oh.
spot there, but two of his four-piece gold spots are outside of his arena.
This is a problem. I mean, Teal is making a TC right on Odette's stone. And that's her only stone, huh? Like, she needs the stone to get the castles, to get the upgrades on the barracks. So she has to try to stop it.
Let's see, trying to build a scout, but just way too late.
Oh, but she has enough for a castle, so it's okay. She has a lot of resources.
Yeah, should be clicking up any second now. The university finishes. Not sure where's the second building? Siege workshop at the front coming up
Yeah.
now. Falling behind her. Are you sure it's a sheep? I don't know her.
Oh, that?
Yeah.
Yeah, for
Okay.
sure.
Yeah, I never heard the name before, so.
Yeah, I'm gonna visit her on Monday, so
Oh, tell
yeah.
me more about it.
Yeah, we were together for 10 days in July, also before the meetup in Berlin, and we are together now.
Oh, that's why
Yeah.
you had so much
And I've told
focus
her
on
what to
her.
do in this in this
Okay.
tournament. I've been trying to give her some advice, so let's see.
Okay. Didn't even know that we had so many love stories here in AUC.
That's nice.
Okay, so players slowly building their production facilities. We are down to 250 years. It seems like Ice Cream will go for some hand cannoneers. Have they got there?
He's going for hand cannons with the eyes. Oh, that's loud.
That's allowed, yeah. A trade card just wants to be your friend. Oh, yeah, he's trading, which is actually forbidden, but in this case, I will allow it. Because it was. Yeah.
Who made it? Oh, yeah, I see. I don't think that was on purpose.
I think it was on purpose, but yeah, it will still protect it from a castle and not intended by yellow, so it's not the big problem here.
Yeah, doesn't look like they're cooperating at all, so. It would be worse if Teal and Purple started the trade route going there. On
Yeah, behind them, yeah.
TI.
Oh, they're controlling two corners there, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, looks like Teal is actually planning on killing Red Hair. But I
A
think
lot of
Halberdier
stables.
will be enough to hold off.
And she's researching halberdiers, having some pikemen already. Plus two, plus one. Now researching the champion line. Oh, and Euler is going for a lot of halberdiers as well.
I think
Teal is.
action is about to start. Teal is. Oh, I'm interested of why they're actually choosing to go Alps. I would just probably make castles in the back and have elephants. But it's look like they don't care about the monument. They will want to kill each other. Seems like all for almost all of the players, they want to go for each other. So that's a good thing, I think.
Yeah, you have to gain some ground first.
Yes.
Like, Red has to fight. I think Purple doesn't have to fight, but got such a sweet position for actually killing one or two people. And Orange has a prime position to kill Blue as well, so. Let's see.
Yeah, that's very true. It's gonna be a lot of different fronts to attack and stuff, so I don't know what Yellow is planning on doing. But he seems like he's just taking it easy. Like he Odette even overchopped two yellows, he could attack her, but
she's even building new lumber camps there without new walls.
It looks like they're not bothering to do anything versus each other, for now at least. Yeah. But Teal is taking a dangerous army towards the gods here, with a mix of Hanken and Air and Stables. Not sure what he's planning on doing with them. Yeah, he's researching Paladins, so bit danger.
So Capdram's now from Odette, trying to reclaim her stone and gold spot there against Red. Blue is building a lot of Huskals there against hand cannoneers of Ice Cream. Let's see how that will work out. Not the greatest fight there from Kane. But yeah. So hand cannoneers are so weak once the distance has been closed against them. Oh, and Teal is now expanding over the sea. That's funny.
Oh. Yeah, I see. Yeah, well, it's good to take as many resources as you can. Just save up.
Wild Moose now attacking with some fully upgraded Elite War Elephants, some Scorpions. But Euler.
Yeah, he doesn't have enough castles to actually kill the army of Grey. So it's gonna be tricky for Green now.
Yeah, he only has one castle.
Oh, he's preparing it very well though, so might be fine after all.
Yeah, against one trap and three bombard cannons,
yeah.
Tough to. Without any upgrades like architecture, this will not be a successful hold, I predict.
Yes.
So what is Teal doing? Teal is now attacking Red as well. And Purple is doing my strategy.
Ooh, this is gonna be very tricky for Odette to hold. Let's see if she can manage.
Archer now going for a lot of hand cannoneers as well. Not upgraded at all for now, but so effective still against any amount of halberdiers. Oh, and now I think Teal is getting a bit too bothered there.
Oh, but no, because Odette is being attacked from yellow by hand cannoneers. She's being attacked from two fronts, which is really bad for her. That's not good. It's kind of versus two.
That's true. That's a problem if you make too many enemies.
Yeah.
And now producing champs against mass hand cannoneers.
Well, if you can outmass with the gods, just out spam it would be good. She kind of needs more houses too, though. What's going on?
Is there 146? No, he has 146 or 180.
Yeah, but like the pop will go out so up so fast with all those resources.
Ah,
she has.
True, yeah.
So I would definitely make more houses.
So Green has a very strong army now. Although actually only the composition is strong. The mount is still pretty weak.
Yeah, and only one castle to make elephants needs a lot more.
Where's all the stone? 169. He repaired a lot into the castle, obviously.
Yeah, it's possible.
Maybe is this a spot to the left hand side here?
Yes, that's his stone.
The one of Euler.
Grey controlling his stone. I'm not sure who would you say have the best position at all?
I like Purple. We're down to 111 years, and obviously it's tough for everyone to have a good idea what's actually in the monument.
So yeah, players, look at purple.
Yeah, so players need to communicate pretty well here.
Yeah, I think blue should start actually try to go a bit all in here, to be honest. Like, I think he probably should spam some helps out these resources.
Yellow now says, don't forget about the monument. Probably wanting to stop the fighting at the side. Blue still. Blue's. Time is ticking for blue.
Yes.
Let's see.
And Odette is being flooded everywhere from teal, from yellow, and kinda has nowhere to run, so.
Yeah, and still missing two gold spots, so. Yeah. Teal still playing at Baldi without Loom. Ten elephants now queued up for green.
Oh, that was purpose castle. taking the monument with the Hussar. Ah, yeah. I think blue could at least have like a unit there to just sit there at least.
Yeah,
those elephants would take a long time running there.
I know green is sending some elephants and some scorpions. Not really sure what that's about.
Yeah, green cannot do anything to purple's army, that's for sure.
Yeah, I think no one can do something about purple's army.
Yeah, that's probably. This is what you're talking about. This is probably what you would do, right?
Yeah, like, I would have done scorps instead on onagers instead of hand cannoneers.
Well, you could have hand cannoneers and scorpions, to be honest. I think these resources.
Yeah, I think I want to be as pop efficient as possible. So, and then scorpions are better than hand cannoneers.
Yes.
Have them in like six groups. Always have like 10 pop free for Hussars, run around, try to find a timing, and then go for one big attack. That would have been my approach.
Yeah. But it looks like they will, or they are focusing each other more than the monument at the moment, so. Goodness. I'm afraid. Odette could be the first one to go, but we'll see how she can be defending versus yellow. Looks like yellow is retreating a little bit. Yellow's pop is not that high as well. And teal should. Oh, okay. Teal is launching an attack for Odette now, so. Yeah.
Teal is launching an attack on Odette? I think he's more in the middle then.
Well, the rams, I mean, and the Hacken and Air could do huge damage at the moment.
Yeah, that's true, especially against Skirms.
Yeah,
green holding the middle for now. 70 more years.
I think it's time for purple to move out, and looks like he's planning to do that. Important that he doesn't wait too long, you know? Elephants aren't really known to be a fast running unit.
No, they're not. So green, 65 more years.
Yeah. He had more castles. I would had hopes up for him, but I think that army is gonna melt really fast to the army of purple. But he's purple standing there still. That is very, very risky, to be honest.
60 years and no one really taking care. Orange can't. Red can't. Teal could, I mean, but will not have the army. Gray can't.
That can, and he's just standing there, and I think those elephants might be too slow, to be honest. I think this is gonna be for green.
Well, it's still 50 years with a small army, but yeah, it does not look like anyone is really taking care about the middle here.
Oh my god.
And blue is not taking care, and yeah, as I said, it's super tough to keep enough vision there. The middle! Blue. And that's dumb. That's dumb from Purple, actually. Because if everyone now goes to the middle, everyone sees his army.
Yes.
So he should either send like 25 elephants, clear the middle, wait a bit, and then go for a push. Or he should just go without saying anything.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Because he knows he can clear up anything that would be in the middle. Let's see, Purple's army. It's 200 with 40 elephants, 40 hand cannoneers. And 35 years left, and it's still a long, long walk. Oof.
This is dangerous.
And now Gray is killing Green. And Green is sending all his villagers. Teal is struggling and running away from elephants from Gray. Blue is still in the top.
Like, remember, like, they have to kill all of Green's army. If Green keeps, like, just some elephants there for, like, 27 more years.
And it's so much HP versus elephants.
Yeah.
Let's see, Scorpions could easily kill those elephants now from Purple. Let's see, Red is coming in. Now we are finally getting into the fight we've been waiting for all this time. See, Green does not have a lot. All those elephants are great.
Yeah, but it's gonna take a while to kill those elephants and those scorpions, to be honest.
And it's 20 years now.
I would spread those elephants a bit around, though, because Purple is gonna take trample damage with the elephants. And
oh yeah, he's having them on stand ground. It's 16 years. Let's see how Green will be doing. That's still a lot of HP. More from Red is coming in. Blue is now coming from the side.
Green's elephants got stuck, so...
Purple has endless amount of hand cannoneers there. We're going down to 10 years. Still a lot of elephants there in the back. All of them pretty much high HP still. Now all the scorpions are down. 8 years.
Four elephants left.
Green is typing GG. Still, it feels like only one elephant.
Oh my god.
5 years. You should micro not fight, and Purple is taking it. Yes. First thing, denied.
And now Purple's doing the right thing. He's going back, saving up his army.
Well, I think by going back, he's losing so much there as well. And he's sending a lot of Harbardiers and Hussars in. I think he's not going back, he's just taking a better fight. Okay, so Green resigns. We're down to 7.
That's... yeah.
Purple now? Now he is the one camping with his elephants. Now look at the minimap, it's so beautiful, like colors from all the sides.
Oh, so Purple's actually planning to go to camp for it now. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, don't blame him.
Yeah.
Like, he knows Gray was weak, Teal lost a lot, Blue wasn't even showing, Orange wasn't showing,
yeah.
And Yellow and Red had weak armies.
I'm afraid they're gonna gang up on him pretty hard with halps and everything they have. It's gonna be difficult to stop it.
Yeah, but for now he's smashing everything that is getting thrown at him.
Yeah.
And yeah, they will most likely throw some more hand cannoneers and skirms.
Yes, that's true.
Okay, Odette now killing a castle. So Green completely cleared out now. Oh, 75 years and no real army to threat the army of Purple here. I was like,
well,
two
I'm
or three.
I'm pretty sure Blue can do a huge difference in the middle.
Yeah, he has so much army for sure.
Yeah.
I think Purple would have needed to build like 2 or 3 monks standing behind there. Yeah, this could have helped
yeah,
so much.
Yeah, the elephants would be really good.
And I think purple's going a bit too far away from the wonder. Those hand cannoneers, if they die, the wonder really is dead.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I see. It's gonna,
only two hand cannoneers left. The hussar is the one left.
Oh, the hussars.
Oh, he realized in time, and now the switch to gray. And purple had so much army there.
Now he can't do it. I'm sure he can't.
Yeah, now he has to go back, heal all his elephants, wait out, and
at this point, I think one of the gods players are gonna win. I don't know if Persia can do it.
Look at gray.
Gray.
And resources. Yeah. He has 4k gold as well.
Okay, yeah, great.
So Gray can still easily do that. And look at, whoa. 8 castles as well. He has a production, still getting gold. Having one relic, getting a second one. I think Gray has a good position.
I think it's going to be really good.
Yeah, but it looks like he will only stay on elephants.
What do you think of that approach?
Yeah, obviously it's not optimal. Can so easily get outcounted.
Yes.
Now blue sending on sending in a lot in the middle. Let's see how orange is doing.
Well, that is starting to flood as well, so let's see her resources. Looking okay. She's still producing villagers, but teal being so annoying to Odette, he's towering in the middle of her farmland.
Yeah, I actually think producing into the middle isn't the thing Odette should do now. I think she needs to gain more ground. Look at
more economy.
Yeah, she doesn't have a lot of wood spots left, not much ground at all, only 85 villagers. I think, she needs to get more area to control. Oh god, this army of Euler. He already has 90 elephants.
Even though blue has a lot of helps, it's gonna be hard to stop that amount of elephants.
Yeah. Blue now building 2 castles closer to the wonder. Let's see, purple now trying to regroup. Blue now taking the wonder, and no one really contesting it. Orange still pretty, yellow's still pretty low with the upgrades. No one really trying to contest the middle now. Obviously, a single onager, a huge threat to the whole army of yellow, actually. Orange can't do much. Even unupgraded light calf.
Yeah, orange is pretty out, I would say.
Yeah, stuck at pop 77 or 60 villagers there. If gray... Yeah, now gray is going. Gray is sending in, let's see, 107 cavalry.
Wow. Oh, wow. Yeah,
26 military in total.
That's a lot of elephants, and I think he has like...
All the waypoints from the castle are at the wonder as well.
Yeah. He has even enough for another round of elephants, I would say.
And for him it's so good that now Harbardiers are getting trade off against Harbardiers, red against blue.
Yeah, for sure.
So 65 years. Let's take a look at the resource of Kane, because that will be very important. Yeah, he has a lot to spam against elephants, but we will stay with Euler now. Let's see what he sees. He sees okay, a lot of Harbardiers there, and he sees bodies dying close to it. And you see her, here's Onager, so he knows that there will be something going on. Okay, and well, they had a bit surprised, and even more elephants coming up, so what's the count? 116 cavalry, so that's most likely all elephants. Okay, a handful of hussars mixed in, and 50 years now for blue, but that will change quickly.
Oh wow. That's a lot of elephants. It's gonna be very hard to stop that.
Yeah, especially with the waypoints of blue at the moment.
But I am missing some hull counter though from gray.
You want some hubs from gray?
No, hub counter, like Hank and an arrow.
Yeah, hub counter, yeah, for sure.
But I think the waypoint of blue is way too bad. He needs to mass. Only hubs, not Huskar. Sending in Huskar is just a waste of gold for him at the moment.
Yeah, is he thinking he can keep the wonder? Because actually it's his control at the moment.
Yeah,
and some Huskars are always getting through.
But he's messing a lot of hubs up by orange, but I think he's gonna go down to the middle with them as well.
It's only 35 years, but it's impossible that they get through. Yeah, now yeah. It's great, Gray's time. Yeah, Blue actually thought he could do it, sending in villagers there as well.
Oh.
Oh, and yeah, he was one bad waypoint there. A lot of Harbidiers on the top.
Yes.
Okay, now it's Gray against six.
That's why he sent units into into the middle like that. I thought like he was trying to kill elephants or something, but he actually went for the wonder.
Yeah, he was down to 30 years, but yeah, seems like teal and red not attacking each other now. Teal actually passing or dead to go into yellow. And now halberdiers against elephants.
It's not patrolling.
Oh god.
That's bad.
Yeah, and then they're obviously just shredding those halberdiers.
Yes. I don't think he's using patrol. I remember I didn't use patrol until I was at 1900. And I didn't know about it.
Okay.
So it's.
How do you know about it now, right?
Yeah. It's pretty common that these players are not using patrol, but it looks like Gray using patrol to some degree, so.
Yeah, so 70 years and endless amount of HP is still close to the wonder. See, I have still a lot of units spread around, as you can see, so that's not optimal, but. Yeah, so the amount of elephants is just huge. And yellow camping a bit too much, I believe. Odette now soon to be going for the wander as well. But yeah, that's what we said. Without a single counter against halberdiers,
yeah,
you're taking the worst fights of the game.
Yeah, and losing a lot of elephants.
I think a halberdier is doing like 50 damage.
And Gray has deleted a lot of villagers as well. He hasn't that much left. He has 64 villagers, and I don't think that's enough to actually keep elephant production. And as we said, God's just gonna spam halps to the middle, so.
Yeah.
Look at Odette. A lot of halps gonna kill all those elephants for sure.
Yeah. Not patrolling. Oh, yeah.
I think she's trolling. No, maybe not.
That's all middle. Okay, 50 years to go.
And now
yeah.
We see this is where none of the Persian have any chance to actually win the game.
Yeah. That's true. I think now the Goths can only decide it. So
I'm amazed that actually have eco to spam all of these units, even though she was like raided by everyone. Like I don't know.
Yeah, that's true.
She has like 70 villagers and still a pretty good amount of army.
Are you proud?
Yeah, I'm proud.
Okay. Now Orange coming in with some halberdiers. +2/+2. 30 years, but yeah, just not enough units coming in.
Yeah.
Oh, actually a lot of units coming in still, but not enough units coming through. And
yeah,
that's the time where you want to abort mission and not send in more villagers.
So, who do you favor now?
I think Blue has a nice setup there.
Yeah, but I think with blue he kinda sacrificed a lot of villagers already, so... But he has a lot of resources. But he needs to make more villagers to get more loot.
That's my only concern. Still not over for gray, 20 years only. Some villagers left there, elephants.
But yeah.
Yeah, but still everything is dying.
Yes. Please try to micro the elephant around and my helps around, but.
Yeah. Now the yellow skirms are coming. It's over for gray.
Still has this 200 HP elephant and nobody focusing it, but now the Hackeners comes in. And oh,
9 years.
Some maneuvers there with the elephant.
Okay, now it's
done. But he's dying.
Oh, and that will be tough for Gray now. Let's see how his reboom is going on. Not a single TC working. That's not what I call a reboom. Ah, now he is. That's
now
a reboom.
Now eight. Type first.
Yeah, true. Okay, Teal now coming in with elephants. Oh, we did miss that. And rams. And hand cannoneers, so that's another good shot there.
Oh yeah, I missed the Teal. Totally forgot about him. We're still missing more help counter though. Could have been more of those skirms or hand cannoneer, maybe scorpions. Purple's just waiting. Blue is just waiting. Orange is waiting. So yeah.
And now yellow doesn't obviously have the best units to fight against rams and elephants. But orange has.
Only halves and hussards and skirmisher coming in now from orange.
But still missing a lot of upgrades.
You see, the Persian elephants aren't really that good against mass halves, to be honest.
Like, yeah, you need scorps.
Can't hold this monument with 10 elephants versus God's Blood.
Yeah. Now a lot of paladins as well.
Yeah.
But the stream from Teal is being denied here by Odette. Yellow's sending in some more. Teal is running from the skirms. Now taking the fights. Blue is attacking Gray now. Not sure what that's all about.
A lot of hops.
A lot of hops indeed. Yeah, this group got taken. So Teal has a pretty strong army now. Less than 80 years. Purple
yeah,
is pretty close.
Could look promising. Yeah, it's also sending more units to the middle, but I would prefer if Teal had military buildings instead of houses. Where he has,
deleting
now.
Exactly in that moment.
Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty clever. Teal is camping now everything in the middle. Let's go into his point of view. How is his production? Has a lot of wood and food. And is producing very much far from home. A lot of elephants queued still. And yeah, everything gets intercepted from Odette there, so...
Yeah.
They should close those gates.
Yeah,
and wall some here.
I agree with you.
So that's a strong army.
Yeah, that is looking good, like, because blue is focusing in the wrong place.
Some hobbies, yeah. Orange has way too many skirms.
I'm afraid it's gonna melt pretty fast to helps though. But orange is making wrong unit, he's making skirms instead of helps.
Ah, purple is now coming in, throwing it at Teal.
You can see yellow also. I think they were like, they will do an attack together.
No, they won't. Purple is attacking now.
Yeah, red is coming in.
Ah, red is coming in as well, yeah.
Let's see if yellow and orange wants to come in too. Yeah, they're... Probably when there's no more wood left on the map, then we can start seeing like people winning.
Red is producing a lot. 40 years for Teal now, but retreating with all the paladins. Let's see what did the waypoints
maybe
change.
Maybe the Rams can do miracles.
Yeah, the waypoints did change.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, he's retreating.
Yeah.
Now sending in again, his paladins.
Oh.
Rams still living? Oh, he was just waiting to let Orange kill all the Howardiers from Red.
To move a bit away and then come in.
But he's not sending in the rest. It's only paladins for now, 30
I
years.
I would probably just not kill any units and just run around and around and around with my paladins.
Yeah, but 30 years is so much.
Yeah, that's true, it's true. It's a lot of time.
What time is it?
It's actually looking good for Odette, but the problem is that she doesn't have very many wood piles left around her base. She's gonna run out of wood eventually.
Oh yeah, true.
I'm cheering, but is it bad that I'm a caster and I'm favoring a player?
If you would be trying to be professional, yes.
Yes.
But
since I'm an amateur, so it's fine.
Yeah, it's still, yeah, obviously like a fun tournament, so.
Yeah.
Pebble has a big army now as well. Let's see, Grey is struggling. What's the population of Grey? 160, so that's still reasonable, but... And not too much wood control left either, although that's a lot of wood, so... Oh, Dad is sending in plus one light calf.
Okay, oh.
And I think...
Yeah, she's actually controlling the monument now.
Yeah, but not for long, I believe. Although, she's sending in a lot. But yeah, the moment purple comes through, you can easily take it.
Problem.
Yellow is camping for quite some time now.
yeah.
Going
this,
down to 80 villagers.
Really scary, like
well, he has paladins in the north.
Yeah. How's the relic count?
I think 2 for Grey.
Huh?
1 for Teal. 1 for Yellow.
And one not taken, it seems. Yeah, it's by orange. So.
Two order, yeah, one orange.
Yeah. Not taken for orange, but... I don't know, if someone had like 4 or 5 relics, it would be huge. But not when they're even.
Yeah, it's tough to get 4 or 5 relics even on the normal distribution.
Yeah.
Okay, one change now again. Let's see, what is blue really doing? He's trying to outspam Grey there. What did he do? Ah, he just ungarrisoned his monks and is putting the relics back in the safe monastery there. At the moment I feel... Is Yellow doing the right approach? I still can't believe that Yellow's not having all the upgrades for the units, but...
Oh, yeah.
Like, him camping now, could this be the winning strategy?
Not if he's not upgrading his units, and I don't think he's... let's see, who has the most wood? Oh, it's Yellow.
15k for Yellow, yeah.
I think it's gonna come down to wood, or like how much resources they can bank for the end of the game. That was
Oh, he
just
just
trash.
sold endless amounts. He only has 8k now.
Oh, that's not a good idea, to my opinion. Not
Yeah.
sell wood when there's not much wood left, you know. But he's taking another relic, that's interesting, so.
Oh
He
yeah,
wants to
that's
have
good for
gold.
him. Yeah,
How
so
is he spending his gold
Oh,
on, though?
scops. He's building scops.
Corpse, okay, yeah.
That's a good unit against lots of trash.
That's true. But I would like to see fletching and botkin for the skirms.
Defense upgrade for the halberdiers.
Defense upgrade for helps, yes.
Purple camping it out now. Teal sending in another troop. Red sending in. People are really wasting a lot in the middle.
Yeah, but it's really hard to tell now, man. I have no idea.
Yeah, it's like super strategic game now.
Yeah.
Think blue isn't doing the right steps?
No, and I think blue and gray are having fights, so.
Yeah, I'm not really sure
Blue
if that is
has a lot of
correct.
armor, though.
He has 140 military, yeah.
Yeah.
Jesus. That's a lot indeed. Orange, only 50 years now, but think that will easily be shut down.
You see.
Although now teal is killing red.
Again?
No, teal like in the middle.
Oh, yeah.
On the outside, they seem to be pretty
But the problem for
peaceful.
Orange is that he has to run so much further than, for example, blue to the middle and teal. So
Yeah, blue ha
reinforcing the units will be a big issue. But
Yeah,
Hussar
that's.
are coming in. He really wants to take it now. So maybe the Hussar can.
Who, yellow, you mean?
Oh, Orange sending in Hussar. But Yellow needs to move in soon as well. Oh, he's coming with helps. Okay.
I
Yeah,
think he
Orange
might
just
be
clubbing.
just trading off his halbs, trying to re replace them with scorpions,
Yeah.
and then go for another big attack. Let's see, is he queuing elephants? No. Is he queuing paladins? No. It will be tough for Orange, although the stream of Orange is still pretty big here, as you can see. So,
Yeah.
he's not lacking production facilities for sure.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh,
But you
but
know.
Teal got it now, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, obviously it's tough to fight against so many players then, such a long
Yeah.
distance.
I think the distance is the main issue in this map. Gotta kind of fight for the spot blue has. But no, I think blue is controlling it very well. And
Yeah.
teal has a good control of his edge as well.
Oh, that's true. So everyone, so orange, purple, red, and teal kind of fighting for the middle. Blue and gray bit fighting against each other, and yellow is the only guy who's actually camping it out and trying to wait. By the way, yellow can't really produce his scorpions because he has so many other production facilities queued up, so that the scorpions didn't even finish in time.
Yeah.
He even sold more wood and food, so he's back to 3.5k gold now. And I think he didn't get guilds, right? Let
I'm
me
not sure.
check. He didn't get guilds. Oh Jesus. Oh God. So he could have had so much more gold there. Okay, where's blue at the moment? Blue has only 40 military now. What? Blue is at 60 pop?
Oh, he's lost a lot. Hey, he's gonna out, I would say.
Didn't we just say he has a prime position there in the middle?
He's not.
What is he actually doing?
Making halves in the middle, but. Oh, maybe he wants to go for. Yeah.
He's trying to
I think he
micro
deleted
trade cards.
everything. And queued up everything.
Ah, okay. Yeah, he's going for a kill against Gray, maybe. Blue trying to trade with Orange, but Orange denying that. Actually, is he? Yeah, he is now.
Orange seems to have a good hold.
70 years. How much is he spamming in there? Jesus.
Good thing Odette didn't go for Teal's skirms, but she's focusing on the orange. But orange seemed to. Yeah, it's.
200 army, more and more coming in. Although
55 years.
The points aren't the best now. Yeah, the five elephant won't do too much. Unless there are no halberdiers left pretty soon.
Orange has a lot of resources. He needs to delete villagers. He has queued up so many barracks and so many archer ranges.
Well, he is at 133 military units, so it's not a real problem.
Yeah.
Let's see, red now fighting against teal. There's a small chance orange can do this one here, right?
No, actually, it seems like he's gonna lose it.
Against teal there?
Yeah.
He's sending in a lot.
I have to take a toilet break, be right back.
Okay.
Sorry.
So, Orange is sending in more and more, but yeah, just not enough units there close to the ground. And Purple's still camping it out. There's still 7 players, only Green resigned. Blue not really in the game for fighting in the middle, only at pop 40 now. So we're basically down to 6 players here. 30 years for Orange. If he only had like 3-4 Huskals now. That would actually kill all the army of the Persian there. And Blue is resigning now. Okay, let's see. Orange, 23 years. And sending in more and more. The flood is very long. Some hussars of purple coming in now, but obviously those aren't the greatest unit. My guys have to run so far. Yeah, that's true. Most of his army are actually on the way there, not on the monument. Oh, and purple is doing a very big mistake there, attacking teal. Oh, that's a big mistake. Orange, oh, 16 years and the stream is long. Yellow now sending in everything. Oh, is he actually sending in everything? A lot at least. Orange, let's take a look. Still has like 25 army there. 13 years. Still fighting a lot. I think he shouldn't actually take the fight. He should more micro closer here. Paladin jumping into there. Blinking kind of. Let's see. 8 years. The guy's giving a countdown. Thanks for that. We have to show it in the top right. Oh, 6 years, more halberdiers arriving. 5 years, this might be very close for Orange. There are more halberdiers coming in. 4 years, no, no, he shouldn't go back. He shouldn't go back. 3 years, where are all his units? He needs to send that in 2 years. What? Why did you send that back? Orange could have done it. He could have done it.
And Blue said no. I guess he wanted it to end.
Oh, God. Why was he misclicking his army back from here to the top?
Yeah.
Ah, this could have been Orange's game. Okay, Blue resigned. We're down to 6 players now.
Oh.
Oh, God. Okay, now Blue resigned, so Orange could actually clear Blue and take this area over here. to have a better retreating line. Oh, now purple coming in with some scorpions. So is orange. This is looking reasonably good for purple, I believe. At least to take this fight, yeah.
No.
Like, he won't win, but he will take the monument for sure.
Still think, wait.
Yellow lost most of his army now. He's just producing.
I think orange still have a pretty good chance in this game. To be honest.
Oh,
well, how about teal? Okay, teal is not doing very much.
Well, teal is regrouping his army.
Yeah.
Trying to get wood again. Yellow is sending in so much with red there. Yellow still controlling the monument, but this paladin will die now. So now it's purple's monument. Oh, and gray is back. Now that blue resigned. Oh god, I still feel so bad for Orange that he didn't make it. It was 2 years, he had 4 hustles and 6 halberdiers or something there. Yeah. He just needed to click it from over here into here and
probably
then he would have won.
He ran Hussar together with his halves in the same group, so they were slower. He could have just rushed in with Hussar and he could have kept the monument.
Yeah, that's so true.
So, very unfortunate.
The scorpions in the back from purple are doing so much damage there.
Yeah, but there's not much left.
Yeah, not much.
Down.
Yeah, not much meat left in front of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but there would be, but he's missing the patrol.
Oh, he's sending wheels now. He's sending everything to the middle.
Oh, at 80 years? That's
yeah,
early.
Yeah, he's going for it. But then again, Teal is intercepting him and.
But not good enough. Okay, let's switch into the point of view of purple. 185.
Looks like we will have 5 players left now, because I'm pretty sure this is not gonna work from purple, but this is all in, so we'll see.
This is all in for sure.
Yeah,
and
he's
this
getting intercept. Look how
look at he's blocking himself at his own gate. Like,
oh,
20
oh, no.
army is stuck there.
Yeah, I see.
And why do you think this won't work? I think he has a lot of army there, and is doing everything right.
Oh.
Obviously, Teal is intercepting.
I mean, it's 70 years, too much.
There's
too
still
much
a lot of time, yeah. Orange can send in a lot, yellow will send in some, gray sending in. Yeah, I agree. He's taking his shot now. 60
and
years.
That is completely out of wood, as kind of predicted, because there's no more wood for her to chop. She lost the corner and she's
now
kind of squeezed in between yellow and.
Yeah, now she's going for teal. And yeah, purple will lose everything. Now we can see him being at pop 170. Let's see. Production. Or this, if those army. Now he's sending it.
Well, I think.
And he has like.
Is gonna stop there.
He has like 15 non-queued stables.
Look at orange coming in though. Look at orange.
Oh yeah, orange has a lot.
Population. Yeah, can't stop orange there. He can barely stop the elephants. How is he gonna stop it? Yeah.
Okay, so purple's out of the game.
Yes. So we will be left with 5 players now.
Yeah. And Odette is kind of in a tough position as well.
Yeah.
It's more like 4 players. Pop 100, no wood.
Yeah, no wood at all. Just 8,000 food, she could make villagers.
Yeah, but even where should she expand? Like.
Yeah.
That's super ugly. Okay, now it's a second shot for Orange. He is now slowly killing the castles.
I believe much more in Orange. I'm 100% sure it's gonna be a god player winning this. So it's only orange left.
Well, we
god,
are.
So.
Okay. What is.
Oh.
Wood.
Well, Odette is Scots as well, but without the
What is
wolves, it's
Orange doing with
difficult.
his army? Why is he going back? Not the greatest army
I
control there.
not sure.
Maybe just patrol from back?
Yeah, could be.
Okay, Gray now losing everything if he wants to take a fight against Purple there. Seems like he's just running through into Teal's base to raid. I'd kind of say it's looking good for Orange again, but he did screw up once.
Yes.
And I'm not really sure if I want to put my money on him again. Now, oh no, he is deciding to raid.
Oh, that could be a good idea though. Like, put the focus away from something else. But he's sending Hussar alone into Alps.
Yeah, well, now he's sending them into skirms.
Yeah, that's good.
And he's fighting with his halberdiers against the hussars of Euler there. So that's the
Yeah,
best fighting position he
that's a
could.
very bad fight for Gray.
Yeah.
Wow.
Orange needs to retreat to the top.
Great fight for Orange. I
Queue
think
up
Orange now
everything.
should, yeah, now should send in villagers.
Yeah.
Now he should go all in my opinion.
Okay, he has popped
Now is the
200.
time.
Let's switch into his point of view.
Um,
Racks are queued up, archeries are queued up, stables are queued up,
he sells
castles
food,
aren't.
goes into Huskarls and champions now.
Yeah,
There's nothing to stop him.
that's so true.
And he could also sell stone.
Just 40 Huskarls.
Yes. Sell stone, it's a pretty good price. And sell food, and he wins the game. Delete villagers. Right now, I think he actually could lose the control over the middle again, though.
Yeah, a lot of skirms there. He's completely out of hussars.
Yeah.
Now Gray coming in again with a very costly army, some elephants, some hand cannoneers. I think that's a bad composition there. Either you go for full 200 strong army or save
Yes.
gold.
Yeah.
45 years for Orange, but that's denied again. And I think this will be the longest game we will have in King of the Hippo. So there will be no show match for the death match. And we might have some delay for the next match. But it's all good, you will get all the action.
When is the
So,
next match? Is it in 40 minutes?
in 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah, that's a problem.
That's a problem, yeah. Yeah, well, you'll see. I think most of the players are watching the stream, so they will be informed.
Yeah,
Yeah.
and random people can also opt themselves as I remember at least. Like, it doesn't have to be the people that signed up. Like, if they can't show up, you can have other players, right?
Yeah, but I think most players will show up,
Yeah.
yeah. Yeah, so, tell me who behind Odette has the lowest chances to win this one and who has the highest chances.
Behind Odette.
Or just give me a ranking of all the five left players who can still win this one. Or left six players, actually.
I think orange, then purple, then teal, then yellow, then Odette.
Orange, purple, teal, gray,
Yeah,
yellow,
no.
red.
Oh, gray. I forgot about gray. Yeah, okay. Gray could be ahead of purple. Gray is ahead of purple. Teal is ahead of purple. Okay, wait. It has to be orange, gray, teal, purple, yellow, or that. I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yellow got all the upgrades now? Does it change your point of view?
Yeah.
I didn't expect that answer. Okay.
Odette
So.
really needs wood. Then, if she had wood, then I would increase her chances. But where is she gonna get wood?
Yeah, that's so true.
Nowhere to chop.
Yeah, she got three trees on the right-hand
Yes, three
side.
trees.
Now yellow is
Yellow is
denying.
fighting.
She can't even afford hussars, can't afford defense upgrades. Yeah. Purple's camping it out
Purple's
now. 90.
yellow.
Didn't you
Yeah,
just count
orange.
him out? And he's back to 150 pop again.
Yeah, I can't read him out. I don't think he has a chance. Like,
Okay. Yeah, I think that's a very weak army as well.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, it's so easily countable.
If 100 elephants can't win it, then I don't think 30 hussar can win it.
Well, 100 elephants was like 70 minutes ago.
Yeah, true. But still. Oh, look at gray. Oh, whoa. Okay. Look at the elephants, he's messing up. It?
Elephants messing up where?
Gray.
Why?
By the.
So that kind of messing up, yeah. Yeah, it's a good army, and he's adding hand carriers as well. Only
Oh, I
plus
hope
one
he's gonna go
defense.
scrims too. At least, yeah, he's adding Hakon there. But he needs the gold for elephants.
And he's having guilds at least.
He is having guilds, yes. I wonder if Ice Cream is having guild.
Well, he isn't building any gold units, so.
Yeah. I would sell so much. If I had 13,000 food and 500 stone, I would use the markets very.
Yeah, I would like always wait till I think there are too few hustlers, and then
Yeah.
go for 80 halbs.
Yeah.
Or champions. Champions would be, might be another good option for sure.
Yes. Maybe Gray is gonna get this with his army.
Well,
But then again, got.
not enough hand cannoneers again.
Yeah.
If those like 20 hand cannoneers would be 20 scorps, I think the story would be
Yeah, well,
completely
20
different.
skirms, 20 Hakoniers, some skirms, elephants, and then you have the perfect combo. And
Perfect combo
monks.
with some skirms.
Yeah, and
Disagreed.
skirms, corps, Hakoniers, elephants, and monks. That's the best.
Oh, Orange doing a great job there expanding now.
Purple
Yeah,
is
I
trying
think.
to take it again, though.
Yeah, but now retreating. See, he only has hussars there.
I think Orange wants to go for it. He has made a lot of stables, so he wants to flood in.
Yeah,
And I think
but
he
he
wants
still
to try.
has so much production back, and he's producing with hotkeys.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he's still producing from way too far back.
Yeah, true.
Where do your cheapers keep getting these gold units? They're the thing called market.
Yeah,
And five
listen.
relics. Market, yeah.
Everyth
There's this thing called relics, yeah.
everyone's saying market, and he's probably like, oh, yeah.
Oh god.
Yeah,
Market. Okay, gray now. One monk, one hussar. Lots of elephants. Lots of hand cannoneers. Now that's a scary army.
I agree. That could be devastating, but.
Orange is very skirm heavy in the middle now as
Yeah,
well.
that's true. Orange has to delete villagers if he wants to go for the victory.
Well, Orange has only 75 villagers. His army is just so spread
Yeah.
out. That's a big problem. Now Euler is going for it again.
Oh, he has a lot of helps killing blue barracks. Okay, maybe he wants to make his own military buildings down there.
Yeah, 100% sure.
Yeah.
But he needs to delete his buildings at home. Okay, now all the elephants coming in.
But there's no. He needs to protect from the Alps. He can't go in now, I think.
Yeah. Although now he's attacking from behind.
Okay, he can go. Oh, now yellow's sending bills in. Oh, yellow has a lot of helps. I don't think the elephant attack will work for
Yeah, that's
gray.
true.
Not the long. It will work now, but it won't keep the wonder.
Yeah, most likely.
Yeah.
Think just too few hand cannoneers. Actually, like, just to not countering mass halberdiers well enough. Okay, now it's Gray's Wonder. Let's see how the players will react to that. Now it's an easy kill of all the orange units.
Yellow has so many helps, man.
Yeah. Yeah, he can take a good fight there. But he isn't the guy who attacks in time. He has 142 military. He might be trying to trade off more villagers and only then go for an attack, and that might be too late.
Yeah.
Let's make this end, guys, Euler says. You can resign now.
I don't think so. I don't think he has this.
Well, I think Yellow will not attack in time. I think Yellow will kill all the 50 villagers, will replenish the villagers with army and then attack, and then it's only 20 years.
Yeah, you could be right.
I think Yellow is misjudging the
but
situation.
But it's not all about Yellow either. You have Orange making a lot of barracks there. So,
yeah.
Gray needs more help counter to win.
Yeah, so 194, let's see. Where's he sending? He's sending everything there. Let's see, how many hand cannons does he have? Oh, that's not a lot, and too many on the front. Luckily for him, now purple and orange are going for a skirmish against each other. Yeah, now all the hand cannons will just die. I think Yellow... No, Yellow can't take this, right? He's just having one push. And Orange cannot produce him. Gray is 66 years. That will be his army. Now Teal coming back with some elephants and a big army as well. Oh god. Yeah, there's no chance for Gray. 60 years, way, way, way too much. He's producing a lot, but there's no chance. How many villagers does he have? Still 80.
I think Gray's gonna lose. Yeah, okay, let's there's starting to get really close to no more wood in the whole map.
Okay, let's take a look. Orange has a lot. Gray. Gray is kind of out of wood.
Yes. And
Purple
has a little bit.
Teal is out of wood. Yellow is out of wood.
Yep.
So Orange is a guy. He has most of the wood.
Yeah, Orange has the wood from blue. That's a good thing for him. That's why my hopes are for yellow.
40 years for gray.
My hopes are not for yellow. My hopes are for red, of course. But
of course.
My my thoughts are.
Oh, that was just a message. Did you just say your hopes are for orange?
No!
Getting smashed down from your girlfriend. No, I just heard that you got a message. So Gray still
oh,
has...
Yeah,
like 25 army close to the monument, 30 years left. Streaming in more and more, but... Yeah, it's mainly elephants against hell of a lot of hybrid years, so... He will not make it those 30 years there. Having some hind cannoneers, some elephants. Gray is still having this after 20 years. Still 20 years left. And this hind cannoneers are tough to see as well. So if everyone is just patrolling in, still has an elephant there. Oh, but those hind cannoneers are so low. 15 years? What's going on? He is sending more villagers in!
But he only has four. Oh, maybe if. Yeah, he has to hurry up.
He has to hurry up?
Oh, yeah.
10 years?
One
Husher? Now villagers are arriving? 9 years? Is Gray doing it? We totally did count him out.
Yeah, we did.
He might be doing this. Orange is mismicroing. Look at all those villagers there! Gray's going to do it!
Go
on!
Guys, Gray is going to do it! 3 years left! He only needs to focus those villagers, look at this! There's so much army, Euler will take it! 2 years left! Oh, are there enough villagers? Let's take a look, like two villagers! That's the only... Where is... I can't even find the last unit!
I don't know. I think it died and it...
Is that the villager on the side? Because that halberdier is not on it. This hussar is not on it. I think that villager was 13 HP. There's no other unit around! He's not on it.
It has to be the villager.
It has to be this villager with 13 HP.
Yeah, it is the villager. Yeah, 100%. It's on the edge of the tile, you know?
Lol.
Crazy.
Okay, not enough time to do too much of analysis. let's just take a quick peek at achievements, military count. You can make your screenshots and do the analysis afterwards, guys. Whew. Euler is taking it. Where is he from? From Russia. Okay, military wood count. 34 dead. 64 dead. Actually, it was a reasonable amount of wood.
Crazy. Man, you have a lot of stamina to keep casting, man.
Yeah, and now I have like minus 3 minutes to prepare the next game.
Yes.
So we will just call it King of the Hippo, number 5, coming up. So guys, in minus 3 minutes, the next game is starting, or minus 5 minutes even. So we can, don't turn off the stream, the players will come in, and pretty soon we will have the next game. It will be, let me just quickly take a look. Oh, that's gonna be a great one. Oi! It will be Relic Heaven, Mongols or Saracens. Relic Heaven, you start with a monastery, two scouts and a monk, and there are like 20 relics in the middle. So that will be action-packed from minute one. So I better try to breathe, and we will be back soon. MBL, let me just quickly check. If you wanted to, you could cast this game as well.
I need a nap or something.
Okay, okay.
It was too much action.
Yeah, maybe I can solo cast or I will find someone. Sadly, we couldn't get the deathmatch. Show game started. But, yeah, just give me 5 minutes, I will get the players, I will get the map. Players are already ready. I can already see 4 players who have to play now, 5 players who have to play now. So stay tuned, I will mute myself, we'll play, I think, one song, then AOC song, and we will go with it. I will do a happy music song.